Welcome to the Bureau's annual climate statement for 2020. Following Australia's warmest and driest year in 2019, 2020 was Australia's fourth warmest year on record, while annual rainfall was close to average for the country. There were both wet and dry periods throughout the year. May to July was notably dry across the southern half of the continent. The year started with significant long-term drought affecting large parts of the country, but rainfall across the year saw these severe drought conditions ease in many areas. While water storages increased in the southern Murray-Darling Basin during 2020, northern basin water storage levels still remain low at the end of the year. In the north and the west, dry conditions continued in 2020. By the end of the northern dry season, Darwin's storages had dropped to their lowest level in 10 years. The shift from Australia's driest year on record in 2019 to more average conditions in 2020 reflected a significant shift in Australia's climate drivers. The very strong positive Indian Ocean dipole, which dominated our climate in 2019, broke down in early January. For winter and early spring, it was close to negative Indian Ocean dipole thresholds, favouring above average rainfall across Australia. La Niña slowly evolved during the winter and was declared underway by the Bureau in late September and continued through the end of the year. The Southern Annular Mode, or SAM, was in a positive phase for parts of winter, spring, and at the end of the year. This reinforced the wet signal from the La Niña in some areas. And climate change continued to play a role. Australia has warmed on average by around 1.44 degrees Celsius since 1910, meaning we are seeing more frequent warm years. We've also seen a 10 to 20% decrease in rainfall across the April to October period for southern Australia in recent decades. Turning to some of our most significant weather events of 2020. The extreme summer bushfires, which had started in 2019, continued in southeastern Australia at the start of the year, aided by extreme heat across eastern Australia during January. In August, extreme heat affected much of northern Western Australia, and in late November, a heat wave was felt across much of eastern Australia. Australia can no longer escape spring or summer heat waves, even in La Niña years. November and spring as a whole were both the warmest on record for Australia. A severe hailstorm in the ACT on 20th of January dropped hail as large as 6 centimetres in diameter. Flooding affected parts of eastern Australia during February, March, and December. Thunderstorms also affected southeast Australia during late October, dropping hail up to 14 centimetres in diameter. The last 8 years have been in the top 10 warmest on record for Australia. 2020 continues the run of well above average annual temperatures for Australia. For more information about Australia's climate in 2020, visit the Bureau's website.